Hello, I'm Deborah Quilter, and welcome to RSI Help YouTube. I have been asked by someone about why scapholunate ligaments rupture or sever. This person is a professional musician in their late 60s, and the ligament snapped during a racket sport. And most people associate a scapholunate ligament injury with a sudden trauma, but I'm just wondering if this kind of thing can result after years and years of improper or overuse of the hand. So here to answer this question is Dr. Robert Markison, a San Francisco-based hand surgeon with nearly 40 years of experience in diagnosing and treating the upper extremity, both surgically and non-surgically. Dr. Markison is also clinical professor of surgery at the University of California, San Francisco. So welcome, Dr. Markison.
Thank you. Glad to be with you.
So could you enlighten us about scapholunate ligaments, or scapholunate ligaments, as sometimes they are called?
Sure. We have a ligament that cobbles together the scaphoid and the lunate. And people can be born, you can have congenital laxity, meaning stretchability of those ligaments, which may never perturb you, but you have to ask the questions, what would cause trouble, either acutely or over time? One would be wrist loading with a wrist flexed position where you're driving, let me get to the book, where you're driving a bone. Let's see if we're on camera yet.
Yeah, okay. I can see you.
Okay. So the idea is here is scaphoid, here is lunate. The intercarpal ligament complex is there. And so if you're palm down like a downward dog or headstand, handstand, yoga, other postures, pushups, you can drive the capitate between those and you can tear that apart, causing a scapholunate dissociation. But with wear and tear, imagine if you had a sharp edge there, a sharp edge there, and then over time, for sudden racquetball type positions, would you be tempting fate? And could you, like a cliffhanger in a movie where the rope's going over a sharp edge, could you unravel it and then subsequently tear it and get a scapholunate with varying degrees of radioscaphoid arthritis and other problems that happen in the sequence of intercarpal instability? The answer is yes. But also, with age, there's greater risk, obviously, of tearing ligaments. I should also mention that taking statin medication for cholesterol lowering can threaten ligaments. The higher generation drugs like ciprofloxacin, fluoroquinolone antibiotics, can risk a ligament rupture. Aromotase inhibitors for post-breast cancer, estrogen receptor positive cancers, can risk tendinopathy and ligament destruction and rupture. And steroids can over time weaken ligaments. So those are, and kidney failure and other things that weaken tissue can be comorbid factors that increase the risk of ligament damage. Again, a lot of people congenitally lax ligaments, no problem, until they tempt the fates. And certainly racquetball would be the wrong thing to do if you have musical hands.
What about dorsiflexion? You know, when people rest their wrists on the edge of a wrist rest and they're dorsiflexing all the time,
it's very doubtful that computer interaction, mouse or keyboard, would in and of itself cause scapholunate. And as someone who has to, in medical legal matters of workers' comp, figure out causation, what caused it, it just about unheard of that computer interaction alone without wrist loading and sudden wrist deviation would be a primary cause of disruption.
But downward dog or something that does load the wrist would?
Yes, exactly right. Exactly right. Downward dog, push-ups, headstands, handstands, those kinds of things. Forceful gripping in a flexed wrist position would do it. And again, people tolerate some laxity, maybe congenital laxity, but when it's torn, it causes a big change in the transmission of force load across the wrist with subsequent degeneration at the radioscaphoid, scaphocapitate, and other joints. So you set in motion a very negative cycle of events, treating a worldwide group of musicians, all instrumental categories and idioms of music. I tell them to just avoid any forceful wrist loading or sudden wrist motion that might defeat the musical hand.
Are there any subtle signs that the ligament is getting ready to go that you could be paying attention to and maybe doing some intervention with before the actual rupture happens?
Well, possibly. And that would be central dorsal topside wrist pain between scaphoid and lunate. But you'd really want to see a specialist relatively early, because uh-huh. they'll do gentle provocative maneuvers to see if there's trouble there. That will follow with standard plain x-rays, radiographs. That will probably follow with CT scan or MRI to just check the nature of things. But limiting your activity, avoiding what we've talked about avoiding, will make a big difference. And also a survey of any medications past or present is very important, in addition to looking at the general self, vitamin D, other vitamin deficiencies, history of gout, high uric acid, so on. So it's kind of a little constellation of things to check before big trouble starts.
And when people are hyperligamentous, or they have this hyperlaxity that you mentioned before, is there a way that you can self-test for this so that you can become aware of not overloading a joint? Is there some test that you can do to find
I think you knew it as a child when you were showing off in the schoolyard, whether you could touch your thumb and do all these horrible things to yourself. Because the problem with ligamentous laxity, and here's another view of various ligament system in the wrist, and that's pretty complicated stuff that cobbles the wrist together to permit a sort of ball and socket, a sliding ball and socket, and then intercarpal, one row of bones, another moving relative to it. That's a very delicate system. When you exploit your ligamentous laxity, then you run the greater risk of both ligament and tendon and other structures damage. And so because you can does not mean you should or must. It's always better to work within a normal range of motion without extreme stretching, either to show off or with the sense that you're limbering up.
Yeah, well, this is really important. I think this idea of maintaining normal range of motion during work and other activities is just really key to helping prevent these injuries. So I want to thank you so much for explaining this. I think it's absolutely fascinating. And I want to thank you so much for taking the time out of your busy day to enlighten us about scapholunate ligament tears. I want to thank everybody for watching. I'm sure that you've enjoyed this as much as I have. And please subscribe. We'll see you next time. And thank you so much, Dr. Markison.
Always glad to be with you.